tiro lo de la teja a San Orlok. Okay. Topological material is very quickly developed concept in recent years. There are many concepts in this area, like quantum Fourier effect, chain insulator, topological insulator, various semi-metals. To summarize, we can see that the material can be classified in this kind of types. The basic things is the geometrical magnetic field, which is the so-called barrier curvature. And if you solely consider geometrical magnetic field, you will get some the material called the chain insulator. And then if you combine with some other intrinsic degree of freedom of electrons, you will obtain some other material. For example, if you combine with spin, you will get the topological insulators. You combine with atomic orbitals, you will get crystalline topological insulators. And if you combine with chirality, you obtain various metal. And if you combine with Cooper pair, you will get topological superconductors. All these things, the basic thing is first you need a geometrical magnetic field. And why this type of material, topological material, are so attractive? Here we take this topological insulator as an example. Topological insulator property is that this material has a conducting channel on the surface, however, it's insulating for the bulk. And then you can observe spin polarized edge state within this gap. And this spin polarized state is robust against the small defects, which gives some potential promise application, such as dissipation-less transport and quantum computing. Then we have a very micrographing, which is the geometric magnetic field of very curvature, is always a necessary condition of topological materials. This cracking at first sight is sound very silly, right? So, but if you recall the situation of normal magnetic field, and especially you consider this AB effect, which describes that when you have the electron and the electrons trapped around a black magnetic flux, and even during the path of your traveling, all the magnetic field is just equal zero, the electrons still get a phase shift brought by the magnetic regular potential. So why not we have a similar story in topological version? In these things, this question do make sense. So first, let's see. When the magnetic barrier curvature is zero, let's add some symmetry constraint. First, we should have time reversal symmetry. In this case, the barrier curvature should follow this relation. And then we add some inversion symmetry. And in this case, the barrier curvature in momentum space should follow the offset relation. And totally, you will always have the zero barrier curvature. And then we consider a very simple topological model, where the Hamiltonian can be written like this. There are two types of hopings. One is we call the intracellular hoping, and another is the intercellular hopings. And there are four atoms in one unit cell, and this system satisfies C4A quantum symmetry. Actually, this is nothing but a 2D SH model. And when you change the ratio between the two types of hopping W and E, some topological phase transition can happen. And the critical point is reached at W equals V. First, let's see the trio topological phase. The trio topological phase is W is smaller than V. and you will obtain four atomic orbitals, which is a pair of p orbitals, s and dxy orbitals.
Notice that
the degenerate orbital in this symmetry always have negative parity, and the isolated ones has a positive parity. And when you increase the ratio between these two, and when it is equal, these four orbitals are degenerate at a symmetric, asymmetric points.
It looks like this.
And further, you increase the ratio, some binary inversion patterns at x point and y point, and some offset parity appear at x and gamma point, and this system actually enter an untrivial topological phase. Here the question is how to characterize this topological natural topological phase. As mentioned before, we don't have barrier curvature in this system. But what we have is still have is a barrier connection. And then you define the quantity like this, which is an integration of barrier connection over the first Brillouin zone. And this actually is correspond to the measurable physical quantity, which is the charge polarization. And due to this, is kind of comes from the topological terms. So we can call this topological charge polarization. And if you apply some point group symmetry, you can further simplify this impression by to this one, which is just given by the parity between x and gamma point. And in this case, this p just have two values. One is 1/2, and another is 0. And the C term enters the natural phase for 1/2. When the x and the gamma point have offset parities. And this this topological index characterizes the inverted band structure at x and the gamma point. And furthermore, this is a vector, not just a number, and it corresponds to a measurable quantity charge polarization. And compared with previously conventional topological materials, usually obtain some topological charges like magnetic monopoles. And here we have some topological charge polarization. One unique properties of topological insulators is the bulk edge correspondence. And in our system, we also have the topological edge states. To see how edge state emerges, you can consider this special case where the intracellular forking is zero. And as you see, in this case, you naturally just obtain the edge state. And here is we show the rebound structure. And you have the for the trivial case that W is larger than V, you obtain there is no edge state, and you always have zero topological charge polarization. But for the non-trivial case, because the non-zero topological charge polarization, you can observe some robust edge state here. And because as you see, there are four types of atoms and the edge. Actually, you should get four edge states. So these two edge states you observe are doubly degenerate. This is due to the inversion symmetry. And we do some tests about this edge state. It's quite robust against the surface potential and some lattice mismatch. And it can also appear in arbitrary directions, not just the x and y direction. And the robustness of this edge state is determined by the difference between these two types of holdings. And even you break the inversion symmetry at the edge, you still can observe very beautiful two edge states. this, etc. Okay, in the previous tight bonding model, we focus on some square lattice. In 2D material, most of the material have the hexagonal lattice. Here we also check the hexagonal lattice. And similarly, we have the two types of hopping this system, which we call it gamma and gamma prime. And similar like square lattice case, when you have gamma equals gamma prime, the energy bands are degenerated at the high symmetric point. And if you increase gamma prime further, and you will obtain the inverted band structure, which on the topological chart is given by the parity between k and the gamma point. And then you will have non-zero topological charts for this band gap. And because the hexagonal lattice is kind of very special geometry, you have different geometry shapes, geometrical edge shapes for the lattice. Here we consider the these two types of lattice, and for this molecular zigzag shapes, you will see this edge state for the natural case and also for armchair shape. And one thing here is that in this kind of hexagonal lattice structure, you have two pairs of degenerate atomic orbitals, which you can construct some pseudo spin freedom in this system. So this kind of edge state is somehow pseudo spin polarized. Okay, so let's look how to realize this material. For electronic material, we are still searching and consider which system is more possible. And another alternative candidate is you can use photonic crystal. In this case, it's relatively easy to be realized. For example, we can consider a photonic crystal, which has a unit cell structure given by this. These cylinders are just normal dielectrics, which you can apply silicon or anything else. And here is some design parameters, and the blank part is just the air. And in this photonic crystal systems, the effective hopping is proportional inversely to this lattice constant. And for small enough a, that the interstellar hopping will be larger than the intracellular hopping. And in this, for smaller enough a, which means that we can enter this normal natural topological phase. Here, for this a value, it enters the natural phase. And this is the band structure of this natural topological phase. And you have two photonic band gaps. And here we focus on the first photonic band gap. And we constrain this system by another trivial photonic crystal. And in this kind of ribbon structure, you just observe this kind of edge state, topological edge state. And there are two Dirac cones are formed. One is formed here, and then another is formed here. And if you look at the spatial profile of the edge state, you will see, for example, we focus on TM mode, and here we show the electric field in auto plane direction. And if you observe this real part and imaginary part, they come from different mode. And somehow you can consider this as a pseudo spin 1 system. So, which means that we can combine this topological charge polarization with some spin or some other degree of freedom of system. Okay, we also test the robustness of this photonic eddy state. And we consider this kind of four types of effects or some perturbations. First, we consider some lattice mismatch at the edge. And we numerically measure the transmission of the edge channels through this topological eddy states. And you see that the transmission can reach almost unity in this system at some specific frequency. And this frequency is determined by the sample of this, the size of this sample. And also, for example, it can pass through some metallic extraction, that's like other normalized states, and some broken unit, and also the 90 degree corners. But we should notice that because in this system, we like the mechanism like topological insulators that the forward and backward pass will discretely interfere with each other. The back staggering is not totally totally from back staggering. So it's but still quite good. So let's see some further topics in this in this phase. The first question is that where is the flux? As you know that in AB effect, we still have some flux at the center of the path. But here, in because of the symmetry in the whole Boolean momentum, there is Boolean zone, there is no barrier curvature. The barrier curvature is always zero. So there are two possibilities. The first possibility is that it comes from the non-abelian term of barrier curvature, and where you know the non-abelian term has the different symmetry properties. And another possibility is maybe hiding some higher dimensions of momentum space. And as you see, you can combine with other degree freedom. like spin curiosity and even Coulomb pair. And we discussed the square and the external lattice, but some other lattice like triangular one and the Kagome one, you can also apply this method. And what's the three-dimensional situation? And here we still have applied some point group symmetry. What's the more general situation here? Okay, that's all my talk. Thank you very much for your time and listening. You can continue through this.
Comments and questions?
Can you turn to the page showing many formulas about various natural? Yeah, this page here. So, what's the meaning of that trace?
This thing?
Yeah, the trace.
Trace, if you calculate the barrier connection, it's given by some it's a matrix because the wave function is a matrix. Is a column. So if calculated, it's a matrix. It comes from the different band. Right?
Okay. So you just sum up.
Sum up the.
Band
yes, yes.
So another question is, I think always once you have a barrier connection, you can calculate some, at least a non-zero barrier curvature. So what do you mean by barrier curvature with a cross?
So the barrier curvature in this system is constrained by this kind of relationship. So it's a bad symmetry, so it's always zero.
Oh,
okay. For the abelian part, but the non-abelian degeneracy may not.
But you said it's still topologically non-trivial phase, so
yes.
Can you define any topological number to characterize it?
So, yes, as I said that we use this topological charge polarization, the integration of Barry connection over the first plane zone, and you obtain this is a topological quantity, and the integration, this gives a topological index in this sensor. And if you have offset parity at x and the gamma point, or y and gamma point, you will have non-zero topological charge polarization 1/2 in x and y direction. And this topological polarization will manifest themselves at any state.
Can I ask one more?
Sure, quick one.
Yeah. Is that polarization definition exactly the same one as the Rastar's original formula? Is it? Is it
yes.
The same one?
You mean this one?
Yeah, the upper
this one.
Yeah.
Yes, this one, yes.
Same one.
Same one.
Thank you. Okay. Anybody else have a quick question? If not, thank you again.